Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another Anno 1800 episode. Today I want to talk about my kind of first big accomplishment in Anno 1800. It is the Botanical Garden, because I maxed it out and today I want to share it with you. As you can see, we have it here. It's not the prettiest. That is because I don't have the biggest island here and I decided to build it on this island and not on the Cape Trelawney island, which is far bigger, and I have some open space here to put more legendaries which don't belong to a set. But let's hop into the garden. As you can see here, I collected all of the plants and I wanna go over the different sets now with you, which plants are in it and what the bonus is. So at first we have the Andean Garden. It affects the grain farm. It gives +25% productivity and the grain fertility is provided in the old world. That means when you have the set, your island automatically gains the grain fertility, as you can see here on the island. And when you have the set in the new world, then as you can see, the coffee fertility is provided. And to the Andean set belong the Guayacan de Manizales, the Espelesia, and the Queen of the Andes. As you can see, all of these are rare. That means you can buy them at Madame Kahina's shop or harbor. You just have to roll a lot so they will show up and you can buy them. Next we have the Subalpine Garden. It affects the hunting cabin, also +25% productivity, and we have the fur abundance provided on the island. In the new world we get the caoutchouc fertility, and we have the purple saxifrage, the subalpine fir, and the snow gum. As you can see, these are rare, common and uncommon. You can also purchase all of these at Madame Kahina's harbor. Then we have the marshland garden. It affects the residences. It gives +2 happiness and the chance of illness gets reduced by 50%. To this set belong the water lily, the common reed, and the marshmallow, and all of these can also be purchased at Madame Kahina's harbor. Then we have the medical garden, and it affects hospitals. The unit movement increases by 15% and you get 2+ doctors. We have the foxglove, the dandelion, and the peppermint, which also can be purchased in Madame Kahina's harbor. Then on the bottom left we have the Amazonas garden. It affects the vineyard. The productivity increased by 25%. The grape fertility is provided. In the new world you get the banana fertility if building the Amazonas garden. And we have here the hevea tree, which can be purchased at Madame Kahina. Then we have the giant water lily, also can be purchased. Then we have here the first legendary, the Brazil nut tree. If I remember correctly, I got this tree from a three skull expedition, and I also dropped it at the biggest world's fair tier, the biggest world tier exhibition. Then we have the Metaxia fern, also purchasable at Madame Kahina's. The purple pitcher plant also, and the sea heart liana also at Madame Kahina's harbor. Then we have the Sargasso Sea Garden. It gives +50 attractiveness and +10 increased visits. We have the Great Star Coral, Madame Kahina's harbor. The Staghorn Coral, Madame Kahina's harbor. We have the Coconut Palm, also Madame Kahina's harbor. Royal Palm, Pillar Coral, and Sea Lavender, all purchasable at Madame Kahina's harbor. Then we move over to the Sacred Set. It affects all trading posts because it increases the harbor activity, and every time a passive trade happens at the trading post, there is a chance of gaining 5 tons of coffee. beans, cocoa, plantains, pearls, felt, bread, grapes, or chocolate. Then we have the angel wings lotus. I think I got this one at a 2-star expedition, but you can also drop it at the 3-star, and you can of course also drop it in the World's Fair. Then we have the Oriental Cherry, Madame Kahina's Harbor, and here we have the second legendary one, the Banyan Tree. This one I got at the World's Fair Tier 3 exhibition. Then we have the Star Jasmine, we have the Champak, and the Tulsi. These are also all purchasable at Madame Kahina's Harbor. Then we have the Near East Garden. The productivity of red pepper farms increases by 25%, and the red pepper fertility is provided. In the New World you get the sugar fertility if built, and it contains the sacred blue lily. This was actually my last plant, my last flower that I was searching for. I did numerous expeditions, 2-stars, 3-stars. I did the exhibitions in the World Fair, and I finally got it from the Tier 3 exhibition. We have the red tiger lotus. I got this from a 3-star expedition. We have the rhododendron, we have the papyrus, the water hyacinth, and the morning glory, which are all purchasable at Madame Kahina's Harbor. And last but not least, we have the enchanted garden. It affects the hop farm, it gives plus 25% productivity, the hop fertility is provided, and if you activate it in the New World, you will get the tobacco fertility. And here we have the yellow lotus. We have the third legendary, the jujube lotus. I got this one from the Tier 3 exhibition at the World's Fair. We have the Paris Giant Sunburst. I got this one from an expedition. And we have the hemp, the poppy, and the meadow sage, which are all purchasable at Madame Kahina's Harbor. So as you can see, there are only... let's see, there are only seven flowers or plants that you have to find through expeditions or the World's Fair. Any other can be bought at Madame Kahina's Harbor. You just have to roll a lot. I think there are different loot pools actually at Madame Kahina's Harbor, so I always reroll like 10 times up to 100,000 coins cost, and then wait until it actualizes on its own. And for me, that says that there is another pool then, and then I roll again, and that's how I did it. And I really found all these plants really fast using that method. And yeah, that's what I actually wanted to share. If this was helpful, give me a like for the video, drop a comment, follow me for more content. I'll go next for the museum or the zoo to max them out. It will be a little bit more difficult than the botanical garden, but for me, this is a nice first accomplishment in Anno 1800, and yeah, happy building, happy collecting, guys. See you next time.